All right. So with more of graphics abstracted away, what I'm going to try to do now is move back into images. While I'm not quite complete with models and meshes, what I do need, though, is I need a second kind of parallel system for resource management so I can actually refine both at the same time by trying a slightly different method here on an image and then pick the best of both worlds. That is basically the thought process I have going on in my mind. So let's get a started. So there's the mesh. Well, there was the mesh pool. Kind of have this to the side for the moment. We'll have a struct called foeImage. We'll kind of put the stuff in here at the moment rather than abstracting it, because I'm not entirely sure what I need. Actually, I do, don't I? For an image. Not quite. Where's the error image? Error images. These things. So these four things, or more things, depending on image views. Intriguing. VK mem. That will do this. So, location. Not entirely sure how to deal with between color image and depth stencil images. And if we can have multiple views for an image. I mean, trying to think, like, how many cases are there really going to be of depth stencils? And, like, all I can think of is basically none? Well, no, I was just thinking of, like, luminosity or something like that, but that can just be a red. Okay, if I need a specialization for, like, depth stencil, I will create a specialization for that. And sampler. Okay. And samplers will be tied in as well for the moment. We'll have void star p next, which will eventually become like the how to import or load, I should say. P import, p load next, something like that. It means I need like an image pool. This 2021. So what I have had in here is not really much for image, really. It's just all I have here are just some very basic. Functions. Okay. Name of the image. Which is basically the same as that. We also have the destruction. And one thing we'll probably want to do is kind of like a private friend class for an image pool. I'm trying to. Maybe I do actually want to hold on to that. Just thinking in my mind, like how, if I'm loaded, because. Okay, well, what? Okay. I need some kind of mechanism, I suppose, for. Being able to arbitrarily start upload. Okay. Okay. What do I need? I need something like this. We've got friend, then we've got the functions, and then we'll have the members. So we'll have image. We'll have some types inside, right? So we'll say there's like standard. Okay, I need atomics then. Atomic int for ref count for use count. The idea is going to be that so, like higher level items such as let's say materials will have a reference to the faux image. So the ref count would go up. That just means like don't that's just going to be like an indicator of saying, hey, don't delete this because it's in use by someone else right now. But won't necessarily load it because the use count is still zero. What'll then hopefully happen is that if like either you directly increment this guy for whatever reason, like you want to make him like a permanent member for or a permanent image like a font, I guess. Even if it's not in use, you want to keep it in memory, so it's like it's ready on the very next frame. Just, increment the use count. Otherwise, you would increment from, let's say, higher or level order items, such as the material again. The material is suddenly in use, so it goes through all of its materials below it, including images, including fragment descriptors and shaders and stuff, and increments all of their use. And of course, it filters down to the items that everything needs. So everything gets incremented by one. The use is incremented, and then it automatically tries to load it without me having to trawl through all the objects to figure out which ones to load. It's kind of a self something or other. Self something or other. I'm not entirely sure, but it should work. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to need some functions. It's basically a class now, isn't it? because it's such a high level order, so I don't need like the, do I need a bool for permanence? No. Because you can just increment it by one, use count by one, and refer count by one. Or just increment use count by one. You don't even need to necessarily have a reference. Yeah, I think that'll work. So, okay, let's get some basic functions. What, just int? Same thing here, int increment use count, decrement use count. And so this would also probably apply to meshes when I get back around to meshes, now that I think about it, because like you'd have higher order objects that would use meshes. Let's say model, like a model's, the concept of a model set, which will have like multiple LOD levels. So it would have multiple meshes. So it would, like, the model set would be in use, so it would load all the LOD versions of something, or everything that it needs at a time. I think. Maybe something. I don't know. Not entirely sure. But I imagine that I could reuse this on a whole bunch of things. Of resource types, anyways, resource objects. So it's like apply to, you know, physics types, objects, mesh items, sound, basically anything that can be like an external resource that's loaded in on demand, and then can be unloaded and then reloaded as required. I think that's the idea. That's the idea. So then I kind of have, what was it, a load state up here somewhere. Load state. Because why did I have this for shaders? Oh, I already had this idea. Up here. So that's why it's so familiar. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I'm basically going to do this. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, okay. So I had this idea, but I kind of lost it in the meantime. And now I'm back for it. Amazing. Load state. Load state would be, so just loading and unloading the whole thing. Like that. But one thing is probably actually for sure is that I don't really need down this far in the stack. Like this is some kind of higher order level nonsense. It's not really needed here. It would be something that's needed at a higher level. Much like mesh. So what I would probably do is, much like with shader, or much like, is that I'd take this stuff out, leave the basics for everything that's required for that, and then move this stuff to a higher level, much like meshes, I guess, where you have like the graphics mesh stuff for graphics is just the basic stuff, and then you have a higher order for loading and unloading, determining when to load and unload up in the application layer, which I don't have on this branch, but it's there. Then we'd also have like a private for loading. Oh, but then how would I? Yeah, okay. Figuring out how to do loading and adding new loaders or importers is going to be a bit of a fun business, but I'm not quite going to deal with it quite here. Not quite. Soon, though. Soon. So let's get at least these functions out of the way, shall we? Move it over. So if these are like a class and members, so I should probably change them up as well. Comes that. We'll actually leave these public until I'm more done with these. So then I do need a to, because the foe image pool will, is it a const pointer? No, it's a that. That which we need to have. Is it a pool? Is it a manager? I'm going to call it a pool. These things don't really move, do they? No. Is there anything else I can think of? Not really. Okay. We already kind of have that. Those other ones are pretty much already there. Actually, I could have just done that here too. Like, yeah. We know what it is, because it'll be up here. It's more obvious. So then what we would have, actually, is... an automatic loading mechanism. So what we probably have is load. Function. What will happen is we increment it. If we increment it, okay. Equals that. If new count equals 1, greater than equal to 1. I mean, otherwise, I'm incrementing it, so it's always presumably something that needs to exist. So then what we would try to do is... we're incrementing it. We know it, so if load state equals load state unloaded, because if it's loading, loaded, or failed, it's probably going to fail again, so we're not going to even try for the moment. Then we'll go into load. We'll try to load it. I don't know if I want to do it inline blocking right now. I probably would. Something like this. I don't know. Just do this. Whoop. I don't know. Where does the standard abort come in from? C standard lib. Yeah. Okay. That's the idea there. We have an image pool. Okay, for the time being, much like in the other one, we'll have public session. Because if I'm loading it from here, then there's no guarantee I'm going to have graphics session or graphics upload context, wherever the hell I am. I could be deep in some other, like I said, if I'm coming from the material, like I've incremented material, I'm loading material, and as part of that loading process, it's come down to this image, which means there's a good chance, I mean, I could pass it along, but that's a really shaky proposition. I should really have it all be part of this image pool instead. Or something that sits alongside it. Like a faux image loader or something like that. Because I'm real sketchy on like reusing, I'm making like image pool becoming like a monumental, unmanageable, huge class of something or other. But for the moment, I'll have to just swallow that and deal with it. Session. Upload context. Not great. But that's what I'm going to have to do. Something I will have to do though is I'm going to have to okay, I do need like a struct, like much like the like that. Which is what the pnext goes into for importing from outside. Otherwise, I'd have save load data. Think. Oh, okay, really, at the moment, I really should just do this. Just blank it out. That's everything I need. I do need this so I can get the graphics stuff. Ugh. Kind of at an impasse internally, trying to think of what exactly how to do this. Not entirely. Excited about this. I don't. Okay. Let's just roll with what we have, actually. Let's do this. We have a file import and struct. Which which has re-imp-32t of what did I get from error images for generating the format, bip levels, and check squares. And num check squares. All right, that's the thing we can add as an import, which is public of that. Go in here. We have a load for that. Static cast. Rather of key next, then we want to load from images. What I basically already have most of this stuff. So what I can do is I can grab it from error color image. Okay, we'll actually error images for the moment. Error color image. We get it from p pool. Was it M pool? Yes, I need to include that. What is it? The upload context? Yes. P image format. I don't know why I still is it not? No, it is. It is. Image num nip levels. Allocation, so it's alloc, and rather it's and sampler. Get rid of that. Put this in. I need a crap. Come on, stop bothering me with that. Let me see. .txt. What is it? Just faux application? Faux engine? Private image pool.cpp, image.cpp. We're going to add it to the end of this. I am. Okay, not quite. Is this because I do not have... that? Perhaps? Constructor cannot be declared virtual. Destructor, please. Yeah, it looks like. Okay, so let's go into the application and we'll have just a function that allows for main loop. Put it at the end. Put it in here. And have a foe image pool as well. Instructor? No. Third party. That actually does make sense. I could do a third party one. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Okay. Okay. I'm just thinking of other stuff as usual. Image stuff. Image pool. So at the end of initialization, which is just about here, nope, not quite there, close, deinitialize images, okay, then all the way at the bottom here we're going to do these two. I do need the Oh, I don't even have any of that here. So be it. Not quite. Okay, then we have this, which is essentially the same. Actually, that's something I don't even have right now, right? It's just... Go through them all, find one that's the same. Again, like I keep pausing because I'm just thinking really hard on something, like future nonsense, which I really shouldn't be. It's unfortunate. But, okay, what we got here? We got most of this stuff in place. What we want to do here is we're just going to create that. It's an application. I'm going to create that. If that, return that. Fantastic. Otherwise, what we're going to do is foeImage star. Okay. So that's deleted as part of that, which is good. We also need to, on deletion, delete them all. I mean, I could make them a unique pointer, but then I need to have the entire declaration up there as well, not just the forward declaration. I don't really want to do that quite yet. Okay, back to application, foeError. Okay, that's interesting. Why is this an error? Cannot use dynamic cast convert to, yeah, okay, that makes sense. Okay, now what's this guy going on about? Redefinition of error image. Oh yes. It's a struct. What are you going on about? I'm designated with what? Okay, fine, whatever. Jeez. Whatever. Is this, it should be public, part of the public side. Deinitialize images, it should be that, that's it. Return that because there's no errors. So inside of this, they're basically what, zero? I'm presuming that means zero. And then we increment that. So that means ref count is now one. We go in here. Stom, dirt atomic base, lock free, alignment of four. Okay. Go in, because it's unloaded, we go in, we say hey. Not even sure where I am right now and why exactly. Go load, we go in foe creating. Okay, we're creating the image. That's great. So I don't even know why I'm here. Oh, image.cpp, I see. So if we're here, we loaded it. That's great. All right. So what I'm going to do, exit out of that. Let's bring up the. This guy, launch the application. That's an old test. I'm in a completely different location nowadays. So executable path is here. And it is working directory is that. Whatever, we'll just launch this. F12, great. Exit out. Now, resource inspector, there should be an image, 2D image. I don't know if this is the one I'm looking for. No. Ref all resources. Swap chain images. No, I'm looking at the wrong one. Come on. How do I look at the image? There must be a way. View contents. There we go. Okay. So that's right. That's the purple and whatever. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so that's the image. It's loaded up correctly. It's sitting in memory. Fantastic. So I'll save this capture. So that's a step in the right direction. Remove that breakpoint. Move that breakpoint. All right, let's look towards importing an image from a file, an external file. Now, I'm going to quickly pause this and find a library that I can work with. Okay, and I'm going to use the free image library, it looks like. So let's go down here. Like that. Go up, we have the load, and we have so actually hold on. File instead. Okay, so it'll bring in what we need. We need the okay. So we start with determining. Let me open up the documentation over here. Okay. File type from that. Format equals FIF unknown. Then we're going to actually have to And I'm gonna actually have to crash out of here pretty badly. Some error right now. Actually, this is kind of a thing. I need some logging capability as well. For model, for graphics, for image. I want to add some logging mechanism in here. Define log category, which is the foeImage category, which is, let's have a look at the other locations, general. I thought that was more. Oh no, this is the, yeah, it's that. I need the foe. Declare that, there we go. That's the one I'm looking for. That makes a lot more sense. Okay, we add log.cpp. Okay, and I'm going to add some more logging to this because I really do need it. Not necessarily for this. I need something for like warning. Count is less than that. Actually, no. I'm trying to do too much. Keep it simple, just that. Just that for now. And minus, minus, of course. error, and we have the text being okay. Include log. Needs to be separate. Okay, we got term the image format. Great. Image load, the image format we determined earlier. Source data file, not see that. Zero for now, I guess. Yeah, if it's null pointer, didn't load. For now, I'm going to just always convert to 32-bit RGBA. Then we get to the portion where I need to actually upload this image. So we'll say for PK format R8G8 that. Extent equals. Okay. Uh, The image function for determining mip levels. So mip max, mip map count. Okay. Times the I have a format function, right? Not publicly available though. It's just, where is it? There. These are inline, right? Or const expression. So basically inline as well. We'll have a few that need to. To here, struct, it's that, it's great. Okay, back to here, bytes per pixel. Are you sure? Include that, which does have this, and aspects. I need the aspect as well. Okay. Color. I need empty data, so 8T, or what was it, standard byte? No, I'll just do it that way. Pixel data. Time total data size. Array of how many bitmaps do I have? Got to go through them all. So four. Mip levels. Got to go through each of them. extent, which is probably an extent for mid-level M. What we need is actually was just an int. We already have a BPP, so we can reuse that. And then data size equals and then we gotta go and increment them. Resize, rescale. Then copy the stuff so the destination is people data. MIP data. Size of MIP data size. Okay, I went through all of them. Then we free image load the original bitmap. That should be everything we need. Now we need to get to the upload portion. Request. So this is unfortunately, like, I only really have a good example here. buffer. So I can actually create the staging buffer first. I believe I already kind of have in here somewhere from model. Obviously that's something that's going to have to be rectified soon. We have the allocator, which is something I get from that right now. Okay, can I actually grab this from the upload context for the VK graphics, right? No, I can't. Dang. Okay. Another temporary item to add to the other million temporary items. Oh, this is 2020. Oh, no, that's, yes, an image. Actually, hold on. What am I doing? No, yeah, I'll do this. Context allocator. Gotta do this. Upload context. We'll just kind of add it to here for the moment. That. Okay. Where do I get this? That. was I? Size. Total data size. Staging alloc. Something like that. It'll become something like that. So we allocated the staging buffer. If we failed, then we got to go through. One of the first things we have to do regardless is create the image, which I used to have around here somewhere. Error image. There we go. So this becomes the extent, levels, the rest of this is pretty much, yeah. Again, we need the allocator from the graphics context. And then here we're talking about like, instead. Okay. Map the data in. So ultimately what I'll be able to do is actually just copy this data straight into here. Eventually. Reinterpret cast. So I probably could have done this earlier. Yeah, wrong area. You go in here. So this, essentially this is the same. VK res, amazing, amazing, amazing. It's raw, that's raw. Okay, at this point, there is the image view we have to deal with. So that failed is where we do the runaround for finding this. And image view and sampler should be still the same as well down here, right? So there's a lot of code I'm currently sharing, but it probably won't last too much longer. From upload context, I still need the device as well. Need to wait for this to complete. At any rate, what I need to do is, like, I don't even have an upload request type for this, do I? Do I? Okay, I do here. Where did I even create it? All right, I created it up here. I'm just not even really here anymore, am I? Map data in here. Upload request, that's great, come down here. Graphic session, and then that upload request. Why am I deleting it from a session when I created it from a context? It should go back to the thing that created it in the first place, really. Yeah, it really, Okay, that's something I need to fix up. As well. There's a lot of things. Actually, that's true, shouldn't it? Should always be on local ones and then only transfer at the end. Otherwise, we need to go through and delete them all again. Where's the device? There it is. That's an allocator, okay. Okay, upload request. Because it was created from upload context. Should be returned to an upload context. If we go to upload, how do we even create it? Get upload request status? Hold on. Where are these guys generated? I need to make doubly sure that I'm doing. These are generated from upload contexts. So yeah, return them back to an upload context. That makes the most sense. Where on earth are we? Because he always goes to a device which is nice and local and quick. Okay. Wait, hold on. He can just destroy himself. If that's literally all that's required. He can delete himself. What am I even doing then? You know what? I'll just keep it anyways. Because it makes the most sense to try to keep some semblance of togetherness on this. So where was I? Upload request. Deletes from that. Let's roll through. Gets render, he gets this, and upload request, right? No problems, no problems, okay. Okay. Just a minor little fix up there. Now back to images here. Okay, this is now that. Right? Yeah. Okay, let me pause while I get an image to test with. Okay, so that should be this, perfect. Test.jpg, which means if I go back to application, it's no longer this. It's, well, we can actually do that and import that. And do the same thing for foe image. PNG,
right?
Yes. It's that one. We go, and we just do this. Hook this up correctly. Just return whatever from here. Got the pool upload context, the image, so it's not p image, it's this. Oh, I don't, yeah. Oh, yeah, you know, this for a moment, and then. Excellent. Excellent. Something went very wrong. And a fine reference to this. Really. We have it here. It's foeFX export. Okay, this is not in a null space. This is in an anonymous namespace, I should say. This is up front. There's nothing magical about it at all. But yes. The thing that actually establishes that it's being an exported symbol. There we go. Or rather this. Here we are. Let's see how bad it becomes. It's a PNG, nice. Reload it. Extent, 960, 961. We have 10 images. Let's go down to here. Hello. Interesting. When we're here at this, and we go into here, we're recording image upload. Staging buffer is real. Copy regions are whatever. Starts up for 916, they go down, okay. And then we get into here, where source queue family equals upload data. Pause on breakpoint, what do you mean? Oh, 120, not. VS Code in your garbage implementation of this. I see. Carry on. Well, it's not dead yet. So, bring up the render doc. We'll do the same thing again. Load last settings, launch. F12, leave. Resource inspector for images. It'll be the last image. View the contents. It looks like something bad. Not great. Okay, 228. I don't know what this is. And what's this one? That's that. Okay. Not quite there. Okay, we'll just say there's one MIP level. We're not even gonna go crazy or do anything like that. M is less. MIP levels equals one. One level. And that's it. Like, I'm not failing out, I'm not crashing out, right? No, these are real things. Not being destroyed. And they are empty before I go in. Yeah. Okay, let's try the render doc again. Okay, so right size, which is great, which is not getting anything out of it. And I don't know what this one is for. It's for something else. Oh, this must be the font atlas for I'm GUI. Okay. So we're kind of close. We've got the right image size, I guess. I'm just not properly putting the data in. You know what? That's actually true. I'm not putting the data in. Like an idiot. You idiot. All right. I'm not putting it into, because that's what this would have been. Fill error data. Okay, standard. Data offset from this map level pointer size of BPP times map extent. Width times mip extent height extent dot depth. All right. Do I have? I think I'm just always building with like address stuff on, right? Yeah, I already have the address sanitizer. It's always there. Let's make sure no address silliness is going on. That's great. We're in, we're running, we're going to rerun with render doc. And there it is, although like yeah, okay. Okay. I can't do that. How can I change the type or the order? Okay, I can figure out coloration later. Because I at least have stuff uploading, which is a good solid step for nearly 2 hours worth of work from a file, I should say. And the rudimentaries of a kind of a self-loading system as well at the same time. And I've got to fix up upload context and that stuff. What time is it? Yeah, I gotta go. All right. That's something. Cheers.